Today I'm going to do a sort of lip product hits and misses video. I'm a lipstick and eyeliner kind of girl. If you've got any fake tanning questions, clearly don't ask me, but lipstick's kind of my thing, so I'm just going to do a little video for you just now while all my stuff's in storage. These are the sort of things that keep me sane. So starting with the products that I like, I own lots of red lipsticks, and I've got three here that at the moment I really like. I've got more than this, but I'm not going to include ones that are, you know, okay, don't really see the point, tits and misses, right? So the first one, of course, is my Maybelline Fatal Red. It's shade 530, and it comes in this nice red square packaging. I quite like square lipstick holders, a bit random, but I do. It smells, of course, really nice, like Irish cream liqueur. It's got no shimmer in it, which is unusual for a Maybelline lipstick. They like their shimmer. Nice, bright, sort of retro red. I do have Ruby Woo and Ladybug by MAC, but to be honest, I don't think they compare to this, and they're twice the price. So if you're looking for a nice red lipstick that you know is going to do the job, it's Maybelline. It's Fatal Red, although I do notice they have another one out that's got something to do with cherries in the name. I'm not quite sure what the difference between them is. They look like quite similar colours. Next one I have is my Rimmel Be Bold in shade 120. Ghastly packaging, I'm sure I've said before, but the colour is fantastic. It's probably a deeper red than the Maybelline one. If you can see, the only thing is, it's like it's got some granules in it. I know it's not shimmer because it's not a shimmery lipstick, but when you reapply, it probably does actually have a little bit of shimmer, but when you reapply, you can get sort of green, a little grainy effect can happen, but just blot it, sort of blot your lips in before you put any more on. And for its price, I'm sure it's cheaper than the Maybelline one, so that's an even more cost effective option. But the most cost-effective, my goodness, I can't speak today, option of them all is this one by Makeup Academy. I got this in Superdrug in Bournemouth, of all places, before we left. It's shade 1. As you can see, like, the sort of packaging isn't any great shakes, but it's not really embarrassing either. I really believe this cost me like a pound or something like that. It's just so cheap. Although you can feel it in the lid, you know. Now, I got this colour because it's a much darker red. It kind of, when I saw it in the packaging in the shop, reminded me a little bit of the red that Cheryl Cole wore to Cannes just a couple of days before the whole X Factor US thing blew up. But now, actually, that I see myself with it on camera, if I was to achieve that look, I'd have to sort of add a berry-ish colour in there as well, because this is still too red. But, I mean, for the price, you know, come on, although I'm just not so sure if this lip's going to last. Moving on to pinks, I've got three pinks here, three reds, three pinks. I'll start with the one that I probably use most. It would be Revlon's Stormy Pink. It's a matte lipstick in 011, but in actual fact, for a matte lipstick, I guess it's matte, no shimmer, not matte as in matte coverage, because it's really quite sheer. You do have to build it up, blot, so on and so forth. You can see that it's well used, well loved. For some reason it's broken a little bit. It's like a sort of Easter Island lipstick, but I will persevere. I could fix it, but too much hassle. So Revlon lipstick looks lovely. My next pink I have here is it's Chatterbox. It's an Amplified by MAC. You can see that that's been in my handbag a long time. It's a much rosier pink, I would say, than my Stormy Pink. Although when I got it, I thought this was such a vibrant colour because I was just sort of beginning to start off with lipsticks. Really nice texture, really creamy. It's another lipstick that I've kind of destroyed a little bit, but you know, it'll be fine. I'll be fine. We'll all be fine. My last pink. pink that I'm going to show you is a Rimmel. Different packaging from the horrible pink thing, slightly less horrible purple thing. It's colour 340 and it's in Lily Extase. Once again, not a shimmery lipstick, you can tell. I don't like frost, I don't like shimmer. A more vibrant pink. To be honest, when I wear this, I bought this. I'm brave enough to wear a really solid red lip, but I'm not quite brave enough to wear a really solid pink lip. But I think it's a really cute colour. It's got a almost baby lotiony sort of smell to it. So that's the lip products that at the moment I absolutely love. Moving on to the ones I'm not so keen on. I have two R.E.M. lip glosses here. Now, spot the gimmick. These have shimmer all the way through them, and it's not actually as bad as it looks. I believe this is shade 8 here and shade 9 here, but I, you know, it's not an awful lot of use for those apart from in the holiday season. You can see we got R.E.M. across there. Yeah, there's not much use for them, maybe Christmas time or anything like that, but the problem is they also taste really good, and I know you're not supposed to sit around like eating your lip glosses, and I don't, but it just smells like really nice cheap little sweeties, and it tastes like them too, so a bit of a gimmick. I kind of, if I don't use it, I consider it a bit of a fail, so unfortunately fail. I have a little sleek lipstick. This is a matte, it's Mystic in 783. I'm sure I've seen one of the Pixie Woo girls use this, but it was for an editorial look, and I really think that's the only time you're going to really get away with this. This is too it's too cartoony a colour. Now, maybe if you worked in Urban Outfitters or something, you'd get used to that, but for me it's just not a day-to-day kind of colour. You know, I didn't get the use out of it that I want. I buy them to use them. Next, come on, let's see, would be Cherries in the Snow. It's 440. Now, I absolutely love Revlon lipsticks, which this is, but this one, it's, and I should like this colour, I really should, but there's something about it that's just too holiday, it's just too bright. I mean, watch the space with this one, but I just can't bring myself to use it very much, and that's just, it's not a good thing. So sad. Last but not least, I have another Rimmel lipstick that I used to really love, but for some reason I've gone a little bit off. It's Vintage Pink, and it really should just be named Vintage Purpley Brown, because I see so much more purple there than I do pink. I really love the look of the colour, but because I'm dark-eyed, you know, dark eyebrows, dark hair, when I wear a colour like that, it just kind of brings everything down, you know, makes me look a little bit like Droopy D or something. It's such a shame because, I actually do like the colour, but maybe if I topped it with a softer gloss or something, but... So I think that's all I have for just now of the sort of lipsticks that I'm really loving at the moment. I'm sure it will change as the sort of summer goes on, you know, before we know it's going to be autumn. Yeah, I hope you're all like having a really good day. Do you like my earrings? They're from Primark, believe it or not, in the UK, and I believe they cost me like £2 odd. I really like sort of jewellery that has a little bit of a sort of ethnic sort of vibe to it. That's why I love Berlin Hair Babies. A lot of her sort of accessories are just quite exotic looking, and I just think that's so cool. And she's kind of got me hooked on HRH collection. So yeah, but now I'm getting to ramble, which is not cool. Have a lovely day, and I will see you again. I'll see you again. Thanks to all my new subscribers. I've had a little bit of a jump in subscribers, and you know, thanks for commenting on my page and stuff. I always get back to you, and I love to hear what you've got to say. So catch you later. Bye.